Good morning, friends. Respected Chairperson, Professor D.P. Reddy. My long-time friend and inspirer, Sri Adi Seshadri. Not directly my student, but equal to being a student, seven. Other distinguished personalities here, and dear friends. Actually, when I was invited to speak on this topic, I have made it very clear that this is not my very strong area and not very convenient on this particular topic, but by dealing with environmental issues, we have come face to face with this problem many a time. And I was reluctant, but I am happy I came here because I could hear Sunil, who has been working for the past 12 years on this particular topic, and K.P. Rameshwar. Sir, I would like to place a few points as part of our experiences working on this particular subject. As a political scientist, whenever we observe our dear country, India, and we know that the whole constitution runs in the name of the, it is we the people. So on paper, technically, it appears as if we are the bosses. And our bossism is actually a reality only once in 5 years. When we go to the polls, on that particular day, we get the real kick. Okay, we are the bosses, we are choosing our servants, public servants. But then, after the election, we the people are constantly marginalized. We are displaced, dispossessed, suppressed, oppressed. In fact, sometimes we are not even given the respect that we deserve. This is a very funny country. We have the world's lengthiest constitution, supposed to be democratic. I'm not saying that occasionally we the people have asserted, when Mrs. Indira Gandhi imposed the emergency thereafter. Definitely we went to the polls to once again restore democracy. But on several issues I realized that in the day-to-day functioning at the state level, it is the chief minister form of government. It's not part of the democracy. And very often we read when we go to any public function where there is a minister, and the minister is never tired of saying, our visionary chief minister. And if that is speech alone, Alusal Jepal Shahusra Munda. Similarly, our central ministers, they are never tired of praising Mr. Modi. Modi is just one among the equals in the central cabinet. In daily respect, daily we have to show our salutations to him. Anyway, this is wrong. Coming to, sir, I have a very important point, and that is this country, as already pointed out by my predecessors, we require a master plan when it comes to land use. And in that master plan, we need to have an ecosystems approach. This is very, very, very important. Very often we read in the papers and in the journals that 33% of the area should be under the tree cover, or it should be under the forest. Then when it comes to water, water bodies, what should be the percentage of area? This country has never specified. But globally, there is a thinking, there is a consensus that at least 33% of the land area, and it is in most of the European countries and in America, should be water. At least in India, it can be, we can work out maybe 25% or 20%. This wonderful city of Hyderabad was earlier very, very, a wonderful place to live. Even in summer, the temperature would never exceed 39-40. And that would be just for a couple of hours in the afternoon. And the evenings once again would be present. But this year, you know, మనం మార్నింగ్ వెళ్ళి ముఖం కడుకుందామంటే ఆ నల్ల ఇస్తే హాట్ వాటర్ వచ్చింది వన్ వీక్ కింద. మార్నింగ్ 5 o'clock 6 o'clock రైట్ హౌ కమ్ అంటే వాట్ వాజ్ ద టెంపరేచర్ 46 47. సో వీ నీడ్ టు థింక్ వై దిస్ క్రైసిస్, బికాస్ ఇన్ ద నేమ్ ఆఫ్ డెవలప్మెంట్ వీఆర్ ఓన్లీ క్రియేటింగ్ హీట్ ఐలెంట్స్. హైదరాబాద్లో ఉన్న చెరువులు కుంటలన్నీ మాయమైపోయాయి. మీ నల్లకుంట పోతే కుంట లేదు, వాసాప్ ట్యాంక్ పోతే ట్యాంక్ లేదు. టుడే ఈరోజు ఏదైతే హుస్సేన్ సాగర్ ఉందో రేపు ఉండదు. యు నో దిస్ ఇస్ వన్ వండర్ఫుల్ కంట్రీ మిస్టర్ సునీల్, యూ షుడ్ నాట్. మనం ఏం చేస్తామంటే వీ ఫిల్ అప్ ద వాటర్ బాడీస్ అండ్ గివ్ ద ల్యాండ్ ఫర్ రిక్రియేషన్. హుస్సేన్ సాగర్ హ్యాస్ గివన్ అవుట్ బై ప్లేయింగ్ దట్ నెక్లెస్ రోడ్. ఆల్ దట్ ల్యాండ్ ఆన్ ది అదర్ సైడ్ ఆఫ్ ద రోడ్ హ్యాస్ బీన్ గివెన్ ఫర్ ఎంటర్టైన్మెంట్ అండ్ రిలాక్సింగ్ రిక్రియేషన్. ఐ స్టిల్ డోంట్ అండర్స్టాండ్ హౌ కమ్ అండ్ ఐమాక్స్ థియేటర్ ఇస్ లొకేటెడ్ దేర్. ద పాలసీ ఆఫ్ ద గవర్నమెంట్ రైట్ నౌ ఇట్ అపియర్స్ టు బి దట్ దీస్ వాటర్ బాడీస్ షుడ్ బి డీ వాటర్డ్. Then they will have a control over the land there. This is a very innovative way of acquiring land. Unna cheru unta lanni kali yesha kabda vet. Government also is an encroacher. Anyway friends, we are all gathered here on a very important occasion. At a time when Chandrababu Naidu and his team, they are laying a foundation stone for a new capital. మీరు 2 పంటల గురించి చెప్పారు, అక్కడ 3 పంటలు పండే స్థలం అని. వన్ ఆఫ్ ద రిచెస్ట్ ఏరియా ఇన్ ది ఎంటైర్ కంట్రీ ఇన్ టర్మ్స్ ఆఫ్ ఫర్టిలిటీ. సచ్ ఇన్ వాల్యుబుల్ ల్యాండ్ ఈ సాట్ టు బి గివెన్ ఫర్ రియల్ ఎస్టేట్ రైట్ ఇన్ ద నేమ్ ఆఫ్ క్యాపిటల్. అండ్ వాట్ వుడ్ బి ఇట్స్ ఇంపాక్ట్ ఆన్ ద ఫుడ్ సెక్యూరిటీ ఫ్రెండ్స్? ఇట్స్ ఏ చాలా సీరియస్ ఇష్యూ. Just things cannot be marketed away like this on the whims and fancies of a chief minister. I have also realized that this country has a very large extent of already industrialized or urbanized area which is lying vacant. For example, DVR means, or you know, all the vast extent of land with where mining has taken place. Does the government have any plan for that? It should be known as brown development scheme. It is not greenfield. It is brownfield development. ఇప్పటి వరకు ఎక్కడ కూడా, you know, in spite of all so many governmental bodies and even the new government, they have never talked about brownfield development. And they should that area be like that for all time to come. And the government is never tired of creating new areas into brownfield. What is happening to Mosi? Mosi has been rated, you know, as it is already listed in one of the most polluted river. What happens to their rights? The Supreme Court has time and again pointed out, right to life means right to wholesome environment. Man does not live by bread alone. Bread is important. Similarly, land. Man does not live by land alone. They also require water and air. And what about their right to wholesome environment? The people of this country, they should be treated with dignity. What is this talk of we take their land and give some employment? And charity is suffer. Is the government bent upon converting the people as beggars? Friends, we have to think. I appreciate the social cause for taking the initiative. And I'll give you one or two examples. Recent in Hyderabad, they did one outer ring road. And you know, just because Sunil is working relentlessly on this topic, I request you to take a list of the beneficiaries or OSTs, not beneficiaries, but OSTs, and also make a chart of the compensation that has been given to them per acre. And you will be shocked. Even while paying compensation, there is discrepancy. There is nothing like the rule of law in this country. But depends upon the person who actually, that IAS officer, all those, that entire hierarchy, including the political bosses. I am also a victim of that, that's why what is this? For how long? It's okay, we are not dependent on that land, therefore we cannot contest. But then why discrimination? Lastly, friends, I would like to caution this one to distinguished gathering here with the government at Delhi. They have appointed a committee headed by Mr. Subramanian. And that intention of the committee is to assess the environmental laws and give a decent burial to six important laws. A decent burial. And they are going to change the nomenclature of Central Pollution Control Board. It is going to be called National Environment Management Authority. Similarly, State Pollution Control Board will become State Environment Management. Okay, you know what management means. Anything can be managed. That seems to be the... They have no respect for life. The air we breathe is poison. Every day, the best of the media is reporting. Delhi is the world's worst polluted area. We are all taking a big risk by living in cities. And yet the government is not bothered. Because government is thinking that it is chasing development. None of the people in the government have ever defined development in its right perspective. They are only thinking that industrialization is development. They are thinking spreading a red carpet to the corporates who arrive in Delhi is development. And times are now coming where chief ministers travel abroad, and when they travel, they take the corporates with them. And Prime Minister is doing the same thing. Where are we heading as a Chief Minister and Prime Minister taking a galaxy of corporates? Where is the common man? Friends, the time has come that we have to question. There should be debate. The attempts of the central government and state government seems to suppress the people. They are going to silence also. It's a critical battle between the corporates who are controlling the politicians and the people. This debate is very important. By thanking social cause, because my purpose was only to raise a couple of issues. I'm reminded of a dam which is very close to my village, that is Srishanam Dam. The dam was built and the Ustis were driven away. Nagarjun Sagar Dam was constructed and the Ustis were completely driven away. 20 years later, thanks to Lok Adalat, Srishanam Ustis got some kind of a compensation. I don't say it's not compensation. Whereas, I had accompanied Mr. Shashidhar Reddy to Turkey. And I think India has a lesson to learn from Turkey. And that is when it comes to a project in Turkey, CAP. When we visited one of the port dams we visited all the four, but in one particular place, on that particular day, the Roosties, ante Moonku Kuraye Prajal, they were leaving their village. Government was helping them with their belongings, and they were all put up, you know, a new colony built. And while enta happy avutunnarante, that is resettlement. And as rightly pointed out, they were the first people to have been given under a uniform, a workable land holding, not pittance, either 1 acre, half acre, model. An extended of area which will enable them to live with dignity. That is Turkey, friends. That is their work. Here in this country, if the government has any respect for the people, they have to treat them as sovereign citizens. Thank you.